Hello students, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So students, today I'm going to start class 12 chapter number 7 exercise 7.10, which is based upon definite integrals, and we are going to solve the definite integrals by the method of substitution. But before that, those who have not watched our previous video of the solutions of exercise 7.9, they can just click in the I link. The description is given over there. And for the substitution method introduction, you can see my video regarding exercise 7.2, in which we have discussed how to solve integration by substitution method. The description is given in the description box. You can just watch over there. So students, now we are going to start exercise 7.10, and let's see question number 1. So question number 1 is integration limit 0 to 1 x upon x square plus 1 dx. So students, this is the question number 1. So now students, first of all, substitution method is that we have to just look at the function and its derivative. So whatever the function is there in the question, we have to take that function is equal to t. So here we can see that x square plus 1, putting x square plus 1 equals to t. Now differentiating both sides, with we get 2x dx is equal to dt, and in the question we are having x dx, so we'll just find out the value of x dx is equal to half of dt. Now in this method we will change the limit also. So here the limit of x is 0, that is lower limit is 0. So we will just find out the limits also, because limits will also change if we are going to do the substitution method. Or if we don't want to change the limits, we can just substitute the value and then replace the value of t, and then using the values of x we get the same answer. But it's better to replace the limits also. Now what we are going to do, as the lower limit of x is equal to 0, so putting x is equal to 0, I will get t is equal to 1, and when x is equal to, the upper limit is 1, so if I will put x is equal to 1 here, so 1 square plus 1 becomes 2, so the value of t becomes 2. So that means if x, the limit of x is 0 to 1, then the limit of x t becomes 1 to 2. So the question becomes integration limit 1 to 2, here the value of x dx is half of dt, half is a constant, so we can take it outside, dt, and the value of x square plus 1 is t. And now we know that integration of 1 by t dt is log t. So students, one thing you have to observe here, that we have changed the limit of x over t, so we don't need to replace the value of t by the given this substitution. We just put the value. If we have not replaced the value of this limits here, then we have to replace the value of t, and then we have to use the value of x. But as here we have replaced the value of t, so we don't need to substitute the value of t. So we just put the value. The upper limit is 2. The method is that first of all we have to put the upper limit minus lower limit. Now the value of log 1 is 0. So answer is half log 2, because log 1 is 0. So this is the answer. Please note down. So students, let's move on to question number 2. The question number 2 is integration limit 0 to pi by 2 square root of sin phi cos s to power 5 phi d phi. So students, first of all we can observe here that sin phi is in square root. That means to make the question in a simplified form, we have to do the substitution in place of sin phi. So I told you in my previous exercise also, in my whole integration chapter, whatever is there in the square root, I am putting that function is equal to t square, so that it becomes in a very simple form, square root will be cancelled by square. So that's why I am going to put sin phi is equal to t square. But for that we need to take the derivative also. The derivative of sin phi is cos phi. So let's see how I'm going to change this. So it becomes 0 to pi by 2 square root of sin phi, and this cos s to power 5 phi can be written as cos square phi whole square into cos phi d phi, because 2 into 2 becomes 4 and 4 plus 1 becomes 5. So now further it can be written as, as we know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So cos square theta becomes 1 minus sin square theta. Now we can see here that everything is in the form of sine and its derivative is there, cos phi. So let us take sin phi is equal to t square. I am telling again why I am taking t square, because this is in square root. I have to just remove the square root. So differentiating both sides, I will get cos phi d phi is equal to 2t dt. Now students, I will replace the limits also. Here the phi, lower limit is 0. So when phi is equal to 0, sin 0 becomes 0. So t square is equal to 0, that means t is equal to 0. And when I will put upper limit is pi by 2. You can see here the upper limit of phi is pi by 2. So sin pi by 2, that means sin 90 is 1. So t square is equal to 1, that means t is equal to 1. So changing the complete integration that is in the form of phi, now it has been changed in the form of t. So students, integration limit will also change. So now integration limit of t is from 0 to 1. 0 to 1 root of t square into 1 minus sin phi is t square. So t square raised to power square becomes t raised to power 4 whole square into the value of cos phi is 2t dt. Now 2 is a constant, so better to take it outside. And the square root of t square becomes t. T into t becomes t square. And opening this by using the formula of a minus b whole square, that is a square, so 1 square becomes 1, plus b square, that is t raised to power 4 whole square becomes t raised to power 8, minus 2ab, a is 1 and b is t raised to power 4, so it becomes 2t raised to power 4 dt. So students, in the next step, we have to multiply this complete function by t square. So it becomes 2 integration limit 0 to 1, t square into 1 becomes t square, t raised to power 8 into 2 t square becomes t raised to power 10, minus 2 t raised to power 4 plus 2 becomes 6 dt. So now students will do the integration. T raised to power cube integration is, square is t raised to power cube upon 3. Using the formula of integration of x raised to power n, that is x raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. That is t raised to power 2 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1, which becomes t cube by 3. And t raised to power 10 plus 1 upon 10 plus 1, that is t raised to power 11 by 11. Minus 2 t raised to power 7 by 7. Integration limit 0 to 1. So now students, first of all, we will put the upper limit. The value of t in upper limit is 1. So it becomes 1 by 3 plus 1 by 11 minus 2 by 7. Because 1 raised to power something is always 1. And now we have to put the lower limit. See students, if I will put t is equal to 0, so it becomes 0, 0, 0. So we don't need to write down, just write down 0. So students, now we will take the LCM of 3, 11 and 7. So the LCM is 231. LCM will be 231. You can just find out yourself. Now 3 divided by 231 is 77. 11 divided by 231 is 21. Minus 7 divided by 231 is 33. 33 into 2 is 66. So 77 plus 21 is going to be 98 minus 66 upon 231. So 2 into 98 minus 66 becomes 32 upon 231. So 2 into 32 becomes 64 upon 231. So this is the answer. Please note down. So students, let's see question number third, that is integration limit 0 to 1 sin inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square dx. So students, this type of substitution we have done in chapter number 2 also, that is inverse trigonometric functions. So we know that if I'll put x is equal to 10 theta, then it becomes 2 tan theta upon 1 plus 10 square theta. And we have done the formula in 11th standard. It is equal to sine 2 theta. So students, let us do the substitution. Let x is equal to 10 theta. Therefore, dx is equal to secant square theta d theta. Now, when the upper limit, so the lower limit of x is 0. So when x is equal to 0, so the value of 10, x is 0, so that means theta becomes 0 because the value of 10 theta is 0 at angle 0. Now, the upper limit is 1, so 10 theta is equal to 1. The value of 10 theta is equal to 1 is at 45 degree angle. So that means theta is equal to pi by 4. So this is the value of theta. So now this integration limit has been changed to 0 to pi by 4, 0 to pi by 4, sine inverse, putting the value of x theta, it becomes 2 tan theta upon 1 plus 10 square theta into the value of dx is secant square theta d theta. So now students, we can see here that this substitution will make the formula of sine 2 theta, which we have done in 11th standard in chapter number 3, trigonometric functions. So sine inverse will be cancelled by sine and 2 will be taken outside because this is a constant. So it becomes theta secant square theta d theta. So students, now we will do the integration. As we can see here that this is the product of two functions. So we can use the integration by parts, that is Eilert method, so which we have discussed in 7.6 exercise. So by using Eilert method, we can take this function as first function and this function as second function, because this is actually algebraic function and this is trigonometric function. So integrating by parts, it becomes, now we know that the formula is that first function is as it is, integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function is theta, into integration of second function and complete d theta. And the limits are from 0 to pi by 4. So we'll write down the limits here, because when we'll do the complete integration, then we will put the limits. So students, let us see what will become. It will become. So now students, the integration of secant square theta with respect to theta becomes 10 theta minus the derivative of theta with respect to theta becomes 1. And again, the integration of secant square theta is 10 theta, 0 to pi by 4. So now students, it becomes theta 10 theta minus 1 into 10 theta becomes 10 theta. And the integration of 10 theta is minus log cos theta. Integration is minus log cos theta. So students, in the next step, this minus minus becomes plus. So it becomes theta 10 theta plus log cos theta. Integration limit 0 to pi by 4. So now students, what we need to do? First of all, we have to put the upper limit. So putting theta is equal to pi by 4, I get pi by 4, 10 pi by 4 plus log cos pi by 4. This is upper limit minus, now we have to put lower limit. So lower limit is 0. Putting theta is equal to 0. So 0 into something becomes 0. And this becomes log cos 0. So students, in the next step, 10 pi by 4 is 1045 degree and the value of 1045 degree is 1. And pi by 4 is 45 degree. The value of cos 45 degree is 1 by root 2 minus the value of cos 0 is 1. So students, finally it becomes pi by 4 plus, this is in the actually in the form of, it can be written as 1 by root 2 is there. So we can write down to root 2 raised to power minus 1, and the value of log 1 is 0. So students, it can be further written as, see students, square root denotes the power 1 by 2. So it can be written as 2 raised to power 1 by 2. And 1 by 2 into minus 1 becomes minus 1 by 2. Okay. Why we are writing like this? Because log m raised to power n becomes n log m. So it becomes 2 into pi by 4. N log m, that means whatever is there in the power, it will come in the multiplication. So it becomes minus 1 by 2. Log 2. So now multiplying this by 2, so 2 will be cancelled by 2, so answer is pi by 2 minus 2 will be cancelled by 2 as it becomes log 2. So answer is pi by 2 minus log 2. So students, next is question number 4, that is integration limit 0 to 2 x square root of x plus 2 dx. So students, whatever we have discussed, I have told you that whatever is there in the square root, to make it in the simplified form, we can put x plus 2 is equal to 2 square, or whatever is there in the square root, we have to put it equal to t square, although you can put a t also, because again I am telling you that will make the question easier. So here I am putting x plus 2 is equal to t square. So differentiating both sides, I will get dx, and the derivative of 2 becomes 0. The derivative of t square is 2t dt. So students, here limit of x is 0. When x is equal to 0, so it becomes t square is equal to 2. That means t is equal to root 2. And when here the upper limit is 2. So if I will put here x is equal to 2, so 2 plus 2 becomes 4. T square is equal to 4, that means t is equal to root of 4, and root of 4 is 2. So students, here the limit of x has been changed in the form of limit of t. So it will be square root 2 to 2. In place of x, I will put x here, I'll get value of x is equal to t square minus 2. T square minus 2, and square root of this is t square, square root of t square becomes t, and the value of dx is 2t dt. So in the next step students, 2 can be taken at outside, t into t becomes t square, and t square into t square becomes t raised to power 4 minus 2. T into t is t square into 2 becomes 2t square dt. So students, in the next step, t integration of t raised to power 4 is t raised to power 5 by 5. Integration of t square is t cube by 3 using the formula of integration of x raised to power n, that is x raised to power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So now we have to put upper limit, which is equal to 2 raised to power 5 by 5 minus 2 t raised to power 3 by 3. This is actually the upper limit. Now we have to put the lower limit. Lower limit is root 2, so it becomes root 2 raised to power 5 upon 5 minus 2 root 2 raised to power 3 by 3. Limits closed. So now students, let's see what will be the next step. So next step is 2 raised to power 5 is 32, that is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. That means to have to multiply 2 5 times, so it becomes 32 by 5 minus 2 cube is 8, 8 to the 16, so it becomes 16 by 3 minus root 2 raised to power 5. See students, root 2 raised to power 5, that means we have to multiply root 2 5 times. So root 2 into root 2 becomes 2, and root 2 into root 2 becomes 2. So 2 into 2 becomes 4, 4 into root 2 becomes 4 root 2. So it becomes 4 root 2 by 5 and this minus minus becomes plus. Similarly, root 2 raised to power 3, that means we have to multiply root 2 3 times. So students, you can see here root 2 into root 2 becomes 2, that means it becomes 2 root 2. So 2 root 2 into 2 becomes 4 root 2 by 3. So students, in the next step, we have to take the LCM of this constant term. So 5 into 3, that is 15. So taking the LCM, 5 divided by 15 is 3. 3 into 26 is 96 minus 3 divided by 15 is 5. 5 into 16 becomes 80 minus, again LCM will be 15. So 5 divided by 15 is 3. 3 into 4 is 12 root 2 plus 3 divided by 15 is 5. 5 for the 20 root 2. So students, 96 minus 80 is 16 by 15. 20 minus plus becomes minus. So 20 root 2 minus 12 root 2 becomes 8 root 2. And as the greater number is in positive form, so we get the answer in positive form. So whatever is there in, we can take common here. See students, you can take common 8 by 15. So we get 2 plus root 2. So the answer is 16 by 15, 2 plus root 2. It can be further simplified as, see students, 2 can be written as root 2 whole square plus root 2. So students, we can take common root 2 and it becomes root 2 plus 1. So student, next is fifth question, that is integration limit 0 to pi by 2 sin x upon 1 plus cos square x dx. So students, clearly you can see here that the function is cos x and its derivative is sin x. So let us take cos x is equal to t. Cos x is equal to t, therefore minus sin x dx is equal to dt. Or we can take sin x dx is equal to minus dt. So now students, we will change the limit also. Here the limit of lower limit of x is 0. So when x is equal to 0, so the value of cos 0 is 1. So that means t is equal to 1. And the upper limit of x is pi by 2. So if I will put x is equal to pi by 2, the value of cos pi by 2, that is cos 90, is 0. So the value of t is equal to 0. So here students, you can see when x is equal to 0, t is equal to 1. So here x is equal to 0. So in place of x is equal to 0, I will put t is equal to 1. And in place of x is equal to pi by 2, I will put t is equal to 0. Now sin x dx is minus dt upon 1 plus, the value of cos x is t, so it becomes t square. Now students, everybody knows that the integration of 1 upon 1 plus t square, using the formula of integration of x square plus a square, which is equal to 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So students, here in place of a I am having 1, so the answer is 1 by 1 tan inverse x by 1, that is only tan inverse x. Integration limit 1 to 0. So students, first of all we'll put the lower limit, upper limit, that is tan inverse 0 minus, now we'll put the lower limit, that is 1. Now students, tan inverse 0 is 0 and the value of tan inverse 1 is pi by 4. So answer is pi by 4 because minus minus becomes plus. So this is the answer, please note down. So students, here we have discussed the first five questions of exercise 7.10. I hope that you have understood the substitution method and how to do the definite integrals by this method. So if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. And thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes. In our next video, we are going to discuss the further five questions of this exercise 7.10. Thank you so much.